friends, welcome to our again YouTube channel. Let's start question number 5 of exercise 8.4, 10 CBSE maths. This question contains 10 different parts. In each part we need to prove that LHS is equal to RHS. So first part is cosec theta minus cot theta whole square equal to 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta. We need to prove this expression. Let's start with LHS. Cosec theta equal to 1 upon sin theta. Cot theta is cos theta upon sin theta. So taking sin theta as LCM, it will become as 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta whole square. 1 minus cos theta whole square upon sin theta whole square. 1 minus cos theta whole square means 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta, and sin square theta means 1 minus cos square theta. We have used identity sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta here. Now 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta is as it is, and 1 minus cos square theta has been converted in the form 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta using theorem a square minus b, using formula a square minus b square equal to a minus b a plus b, a minus b a plus b. Now 1 minus cos theta is cancelled out from 1 minus cos theta, and it is remained with 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta, hence proof. Next part is cos a upon 1 plus sin a plus 1 plus sin a upon cos a is need to be proved as 2 sec a. Let's take 1 plus sin a into cos a as LCM. It will become cos a into cos a, cos square a, and this will become 1 plus sin a into 1 plus sin a, that is 1 plus sin a whole square. 1 plus sin a whole square can be written as a square plus b square plus 2ab, 1 square plus sin a square a plus 2 into 1 into sin a. Now cos square a plus sin square a is equal to 1. 1 and 1 becomes 2 plus 2 sin a upon 1 plus sin a cos a. Taking 2 as a common, we will write it as 2 common 1 plus sin a upon 1 plus sin a cos a. 1 plus sin a into 1 plus sin a will be cancelled out, and it will remain as 2 upon cos a. 1 by cos a may be written as sec a. So this has been converted into RHS, that is 2 sec a. Let's start third part. We need to show that tan theta upon 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta upon 1 minus tan theta is equal to 1 plus sec theta cosec theta. Write tan theta in the form of sin by cos and cot in form of cos upon sin. It will become as sin theta upon cos theta plus 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta, and this will convert into cos theta upon sin theta upon 1 minus sin theta upon cos theta. Taking sin theta as LCM, it will become sin theta minus cos theta, and sin theta will go upward, and it will become sin square theta upon cos theta and sin theta minus cos theta. Similarly, cos theta will go upward, it will become cos square theta, and this sin theta is here, and this is cos theta minus sin theta. From this expression, we can take LCM as cos theta, sin theta, sin theta minus cos theta. Cos theta, sin theta minus cos theta, and sin theta. When we divide this by this, we will find, we will get sin theta, and this will become sin theta into sin square theta, sin cube theta. And when we divide it by this expression, then we will get minus cos theta. Minus cos theta into cos square theta is cos cube theta. Now a cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b, a square plus ab plus b square, or a square plus b square plus ab. So sin cube theta minus cos cube theta may be written as sin theta minus cos theta a minus b into a square plus b square plus ab, sin square theta plus cos square theta plus sin theta cos theta upon sin theta minus cos theta sin theta. Sin theta minus cos theta and sin theta minus cos theta cancelled out. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1 using identity. So this is 1 plus sin theta cos theta upon sin theta cos theta. That is 1 upon sin theta cos theta plus sin theta cos theta upon sin theta cos theta. sin theta cos theta upon sin theta cos theta will become 1, and 1 upon sin theta cos theta is 1 by sin theta into 1 by cos theta. 1 by sin theta is cosec theta and 1 by cos theta is sec theta. Therefore, this LHS has been converted into cosec theta sec theta plus 1, that is RHS. In fourth question, we need to prove that 1 plus sec a upon sec a is equal to sin square a upon 1 minus cos a. Sec a may be written in the form of 1 by cos a. Similarly, this sec a may also be written in form of 1 by cos a. It will become cos a plus 1 upon cos a, and it is 1 upon cos a. Cos a will be cut out from cos a, and it will remain as 1 plus cos a only. Then we are to convert it into this form. So let's multiply and divide with 1 minus cos a. 1 plus cos a into 1 minus cos a is a plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square, and 1 square minus cos square a upon 1 minus cos a. 1 square minus cos square a is 1 minus cos square a is sin square upon 1 minus cos a. Hence proved. Part 5 is, we need to prove that cos a minus sin a plus 1 upon cos a plus sin a minus 1 is equal to cos a k plus cot a. Divide both sides, numerator and denominator, by sin a. Cos by sin is cot, sin by 1 by sin is cos a, and sin by sin is 1. Similarly, cos by sin is cot, 1 by sin is cos a, and sin a by sin a is 1. Now, write this 1 is cos a square a minus cot square a, and denominator write as it is. Cot a plus cos a k minus cos a square a minus cot square a is equal to cos a k minus cot a into cos a k plus cot a minus b a plus b. Then take cot a plus cos a k is common from both expression. When we take out cot a plus cos a k, then here we will get 1 plus cot a minus cos a k. Okay, we will get 1 minus cos a k minus cot a, that will become 1 plus cot a minus cos a k, and denominator is cot a minus cos a k plus 1, which may be written as 1 plus cot a minus cos a k. These both expressions are same, then that is why these will cancel out, and it will become cot a plus cos a k, which is equal to right hand side expression. So we will discuss next 5 sections in next video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel.